Thank you for the opportunity. It's partly artistic, mainly, but also scientific, because it's about visual communication, what I want to point out. In European prehistory, encrusted decoration was used from the late Neolithic, and many archaeological cultures, such as the Babeker culture too, applied this technique. In my presentation, first, I'm going through the common mistakes of the illustrations. Then we will see some good examples as well. Somehow, it's don't want to go further. No, still not. Yeah, thank you very much. So in this presentation, I'm showing the Babeker examples, but also, as you see here, it's from the Transdanubian encrusted pottery culture from the Middle Bronze Age, and it will be a few examples from the Ljubljana culture from the Early Bronze Age. So the first problem, first type of mistakes, as you can see here, these horizontal lines on that rim are depicting many parallel lines horizontally and vertically as well. It's made by a tool called rolled stick. So in this drawings, it should be ignored because it was covered later with the white encrustation. As Jan also pointed out, this phenomenon on the morning presentation, I'm going deeper in this topic and just want to emphasize the importance about this. Also, on the base, you can on the bottom picture, you can see these oval parts which are not exist in the real life. Here is two shirts from the same culture, the same technique. You see the difference, the left without incrustation. There is no any trace in it, but definitely they made to fill with incrustation, and you see the well preserved one there. Also here you can see these oval impressions in the middle, and these are made only to create this zigzag line. So for example, in the light of this, that presentation of this vessel is so wrong, unfortunately, because there are no in the original concept, there are no oval dots there. And also this picture shows the second type of mistake, when the illustration made only by lines, which means the original dark and white contrast is totally ignored. It's like when we depicting a chessboard with lines and we get a grid, with this we lose the whole concept of the game. We cannot understand anything about it. And unfortunately, this tradition in the all encrusted pottery illustrations are so deeply rooted and very well spread. And in recent studies also, of course, or unfortunately, these methods followed, these wrong kind of methods, even in studies when particularly they want to understand specific motifs. And for example, this one, is should be the same zigzag line. So here it's not the triangles what are important, but the zigzag line in the middle. The third mistake, but I partly mentioned, is presented with this picture. Can anyone recognize this famous person? Ah, yes. But much more easier to recognize like this. Most famous archaeologists in Hollywood, yeah. So the problem is with these decorations is the same. Partly we can recognize if your brain is well trained to see the original many times and the bad kind of illustration. Of course, you can switch it somehow, but it's really hard. And many examples exist. For example, this one, and here it's also plus added a smaller problem. This dotting style, which is, if I may say, it's giving noise to the information, which is irrelevant to the information. And generally, I know it's also very, very commonly used. But if we think with hands, we can produce 25 or 50 dots per inch, which is a very low resolution. So in the age when we should give illustration to the print or the editors, minimum 300 dots per inch resolution, there is no point to use it anymore. I think this was developed for certain press technique, but the press could deal with it, and maybe it's easier for everyone to create graphics, but these are not the best solutions. It's much easier to nowadays to produce real graphics, scan it, and change it a little bit, and then the press can deal with it. It's here it's also an example from this pointing method, and as I reconstructed what was the original concept. I think you can see the difference. And of course, there are some good examples, not so much. I find only three publications, but one of them is more than 100 years old. The another one is also from the 1950s. So the idea is it was presented, but somehow it didn't spread. And from the early 2000, there was also one publication which was playing with this idea and done some good reconstructions. And even they do two versions. On the right side is the, let's say, the freshly encrusted vessel, and the other one is used or not really covered. And of course, here it's there is a technical or methodological question. It was really covered with white incrustation totally or not. I guess it's not, because as we see the in this stripe, the lines are many times are changing the direction, so it should reflect somehow in the original concept. And also with this method, we can see particular parts, as I here is the squares, the black squares, what I call it inverse motifs, because usually when you create a motif on a vessel, the line what you draw, this is the motif, but here the motive is the untouched part, which is more prompt after when it's filled with incrustation. And of course, there are some good examples when the incrustation is well preserved, and there is no question. And here's just I'm going to show some example how reconstructions can be made and the patterns can be more much better understand. And for this reconstruction, I find a very useful method to put a paper on the ceramic and grab with a thick graphite pencil, like in the rock art Darkoji using this, so you can copy exactly the motifs or the patterns, and then you can work with it in for example in Photoshop, make the white part highlighted, and then this you can distort on the vessel, and this big vessel shows that even it's a 40 centimeter high vessel with a very small details can be represented without any corruption of the motif, because with the previously shown wrong kind of method you cannot even do these details, because the thickness of the line what you use cannot so it's just sometimes impossible, and instead of doing exactly what should be on you will do less zigzag, for example. Also, it's just examples, some reconstruction to show. I think it's very dramatically shows that this funnel has a very different occurrence if we reconstruct rightly. The pattern and the zigzag line become very become the motive instead of something else. And in this object also, I think it's just this kind of 3D deepness, what is in it. It's amazing. And so it's, I just want to say to everyone that please in the future try to do this kind of approach, because it's really understand really important basic step to understand the motive what we were talking all day about it. And thank you for your attention.